Hello and welcome to this UniTaster OnDemand event today. My name is John Cheek. I'm the founder of UniTasterDays and I'm going to be introducing this event, which essentially means I'm going to introduce our speaker and the topic that the speaker will be talking about. The subject area we're going to be looking at today is optometry, and I'm absolutely delighted to be joined by Dr. Jennifer Acton, who's joining us from Cardiff University. Jennifer is a senior lecturer with the School of Optometry and Vision Sciences at Cardiff University, and she's going to introduce what studying optometry at university might well involve. So it might include things like what you might expect on the course, reasons to consider university courses in optometry, careers and application tips, and maybe lots more as well. With that, always conscious you've tuned in to hear from our speaker, not from myself, I'll pass things over to Dr. Jennifer Acton, joining us from Cardiff University. Over to you, Jennifer.
Hello, my name's Jennifer, and as well as a lecturer, I'm also an optometrist based at Cardiff University. And I'm going to tell you a bit about what an optometrist does and also what our students do and how to apply. So optometrists are key healthcare workers. They are primary healthcare professionals who can examine, diagnose, treat, and manage people with eye problems. With further training, optometrists can also prescribe medications and perform certain procedures. And optometrists can also prescribe contact lenses, spectacle lenses, low vision aids as part of low vision rehabilitation. There are so many reasons why to choose optometry as a career. And it's very easy to find work. There are lots of job opportunities for optometrists on the high street or in the hospital and internationally. Depending on the country, there may be additional training if you want to work as an optometrist in another country. It's such a rewarding career, especially if you like helping people and really improving the quality of life of your patients. As a job, it lends itself very well to people who want to work part-time as well. I'm just showing some pictures of the typical learning environment as a student. This is one of our undergraduate clinical spaces with individual cubicles to practice in, and this is what you'd see in most optometry schools. These are some students learning clinical techniques. In this example, at the top here, they've just seen a patient and they're receiving feedback on how did they do, and down at the bottom, another is practicing a clinical technique where they're putting some orange dye into the eye. Most of these pictures are pre-COVID, however, but since COVID, we've put in place some additional measures. So these are students seeing patients in full PPE with additional hygiene and cleaning measures in place, which is the same across other institutions, of course. And much of these additional hygiene measures, I think, are here to stay. I'm now showing some examples of technology used in optometry. So this is an example of imaging technology in which we use an instrument to take a photo of the retina, that's the lining at the back of the eye. And this technique is called optical coherence tomography, or OCT for short. And in this technique, it takes a picture. First of all, there's what we call the on-face view of the retina. That's this orange one on the side here. But it also takes a cross-sectional image, which you can see in black and white, where you can see all of the layers cutting across the retina. And the students learn to acquire and interpret OCT images to inform their clinical decision making. Now, their learning is supported by going through clinical cases. And this is an example of a patient with problems affecting different parts of the eye. So problems affecting at the macula, which is the part of the retina that they use for fine detailed vision, and also the vitreous, which is the jelly inside the eye. And this is some more case-based discussions going on. As well as the clinical component, optometry is also a general science degree, and basic science practicals are carried out. Here we have pictures of an anatomy lesson, also a microbiology practical as part of a biochemistry module, and also a microscopy teaching session. Clinical placements form an important part of the learning to become an optometrist, with a mixture of both on-site clinical placements as well as external placements, perhaps in the hospital or in the community. Now, there are a few different pathways to becoming a qualified optometrist. I'm just showing you one module here, which is that graduating students who have completed their optometry degree then go on to the next step, and they must gain at least a lower second degree classification, that is a 2-2 degree outcome, to go on to the next step, which is a pre-registration year. And that's a supervised year out in practice before taking final exams to become a fully registered optometrist, which is when they can register with the General Optical Council. Optometry is now such a rapidly developing and exciting area, and there are so many different areas to specialise in, which you can do as a postgraduate student. So optometrists can undergo further training in glaucoma, in low vision, in paediatric optometry, in binocular vision, also independent prescribing. And in this picture is an optometrist who underwent further training to be able to deliver an eye injection to treat a disease called macular degeneration. And what all of this means now is that there are new eye care pathways in Wales and elsewhere in which patients can be seen by the optometrist in the community rather than having to go to the hospital for some of their appointments. As with other subjects, you can apply through UCAS. The entry requirements do vary with institution, but there are different courses for people doing either sciences at A-levels and also other courses for people who are not doing sciences at A-levels, or for those with non-standard qualifications. In your personal statement, I think it's really important to write about any optometry or healthcare related work experience if you've done that. Or as an alternative, perhaps you have experience as a patient, or perhaps you've interviewed an optometrist. And the other thing to write about in terms of your personal skills, perhaps you do some hobbies where you've gained transferable skills, things like teamwork or leadership or manual dexterity. So if you're good at science and you like helping people and you're interested in a healthcare career, then perhaps optometry is for you. Thank you for listening.